Well, buddies, we just got hit by another camper who was parking behind us.
Hop in, babe, we're going.
Woohoo!
Well, your new friends from the Netherlands used to have a house left into the mud, but an old RV called Penelope, she's a 1983. Pictures and patterns of design. Penelope loves Rob until the end of time. Well, RVlicious, if you like a vibe, please subscribe. Please
subscribe. Looks like Penelope is not hurt, but their bumper is damaged.
Need a little heater fan. It connects to the Gold Zero. Output is 1 watt. It's a laptop USB fan. And on our shower curtain rod.
Curtain
rod. So it's very handy. Keeps me nice and cool. So
cool bear is a happy bear.
Yes, we were just brewing our coffee when we got hit. Title secured. by an arriving camper van who tried to park behind us. So we heard a huge scratching noise.
Yeah.
And gave us a little bit of a scare.
Yes, but he was a whoa.
So then, of course, in my athletic shape, I jumped out and just to see what was up. And Penny was all right. There's in our bumper, there's a little dent. You hardly see it.
Nope.
And the other camper is a more modern camper, and they had their front bumper completely dented in.
Yep.
And it was a nice couple inside. They were just starting their vacation to the Pyrenees, the mountains, the Pyrenees in France. And they wanted to have a little stop here. Mm-hmm. And yeah, you're already with your head in the clouds of the vacation, and then something like this happens, and I immediately reassured them. I said, "Don't worry, I had the same thing happen to me in our first year."
Yep.
And I mean, Penelope is an old lady,
tough.
She's tough. So a little dent adds character. So they did offer to compensate us, but I said no, that's not necessary at all, and we don't need to profit from an accident. And yeah, they were glad about that, but they were unhappy about that dent. So they went to call their garage, and I think because it's a very lightweight bumper, it easily dents in, but it probably also easily dents out. They had a lot of, it was a pretty big dent, and there was some part of the bumper was, I think, cracked, but we're glad it's just something like this. I mean, we can move on, they can move on, and nobody's hurt physically, maybe just a bruised ego, because if you hit something, then your ego is more bruised than anything, and better the ego than your body or anything else. So we're marrying on a little way. And yeah, I'm glad we got a clickbait title. So. Content creates itself sometimes, even when you're parked.
Yes, you just have to sit back and watch the content ride in or roll in this case.
So the couple with the dent, they just went to the garage.
Yes.
Two screws out, a blow dryer, a hammer, and they returned to show us it's all fixed.
Yep.
They were very happy campers.
Yes.
And we too.
Yes. Which makes us happy campers too. Everybody happy. Kijk hoe lief het is. Kantoortuin. Yes, buddy.
Hello, Winnie.
You gonna watch? Awesome. Well, these are the whatchamacallit?
Instructions.
Instructions. Let's see if I can understand it. Yes.
So this is a pay.
Paying area.
Paying area.
Wow. Yes, buddies.
Bad news.
Bad news.
What's up with that, buddies?
Yes, as we thought. We thought first that because we got the city pass, we could get the new ID for free. But nope. It seems to have expired.
Expired? What's up with that, buddies?
So I had to pay the full 50...
50 bucks.
50 bucks.
And how many cents?
65 cents.
Wow. Yes, they give you, because you have a low income, you have this pass.
City pass.
And then first they accepted it, and then they said, no, it's not valid anymore. But there's no expiration date on the pass either.
Exactly.
So we don't know.
Yeah.
It's just all a big scam, the government scam.
Exactly. For all we know, they could have been making it up. Yes.
Yes. So they lift up your spirits and then they crush you down.
Well, buddies, we're going to pay a surprise visit to my mother. We're gonna get our mail. Seeing we were here anyway, might as well see if she's home.
Da 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 da. just want to be respected. My love,
I just wanna be respected.
My love,
just wanna be respected.
I just wanna be respected. I love protected, protected. Stop her lies.
Yes, buddies, we're in Sneek. It's a town in Frostland, and we're gonna check out a camper spot there.
Yes, let's hope there's room.
Nice tower.
The other side of the water.
Yes. Why didn't they send us right there, right away? I don't know what to do.
Look at boats. Campers. Washing place for Penelope. We have, that's one thing that we have not found yet in these 3 years. So, yeah, we did see one, but you're not always near there, so to say. Let's see. People have put the awnings out,
yes.
And the places are so narrow that the end of the awning. Hello.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, is that a Nederlandse? Oh, yeah.
one is not best.
Yeah, that Dutch vision. Yeah, die hebben beide die Leuvel. Daar past maar niet goed rein.
So, ja, wir sind ja noch länger. Wir haben 7 Meter.
Ah.
Fast drei da vorne.
Okay.
Oh, Dankeschön.
It was just too narrow, put the awnings out,
yeah.
And the woman said it fits, but yeah, she wants to make money, of course.
Yep.
But it was too close for comfort. For a second. All about first vibes. It's the first vibe, there was two awnings out, and that means that they don't respect somebody who might pull in after them. We never put the awning out if there's no roof. We never put the awning out to begin with because it's broken. So we're just gonna, that tells you something about the people you're gonna stand next to, we think.
Yep.
We understand you want to sit under an awning, but if there's no room for the awning, and
yes, exactly.
We both had the vibe, so even though the woman wanted to show us a spot,
seemed very nice.
Seemed very nice, a German lady.
Yep.
We're gonna go.
So, buddies, we're moving on. On to the next one.
Yeah, the thing is, if you're the harbor master or mistress, and the places are so narrow that you have to put your awning on another free camper spot.
Mm.
Then if you're the harbor master, you should tell these people, sorry, no awnings allowed.
Yep.
It's just not, there's no room for it.
Yep.
And you always have to say, you can say, well, there's nobody standing there, but always people can come.
Yep.
So it's the harbor, it's not the people's fault.
Nope.
But harbor master or harbor mistress,
yep,
they should say sorry. You can sit in front of the camper.
Yep.
You can sit behind the camper, mm-hmm. but you cannot sit on the awning. So it's one of those things. Because then I could have pulled in. Now both two awnings,
yep.
they were both sticking out a little bit on the camper spot that we could choose from.
Yep.
So, the harbor master should do that in advance,
yes.
and not respond afterwards
nope.
when the guests come and cannot park. Because now our vibe is, what's up with that, buddies? Why are these awnings on our spots or on the free spots?
Yep.
So that's for the harbor masters and mistresses out there. That's free advice from our Felicis, for what it's worth.
Yes. And besides, if somebody is has settled in and put out the awning, you don't want to be that couple who
the awning poopers. Yes.
So that people have to break off their awning.
And like I said, it's the harbor master who should not allow it. I mean, what if we would want to put out the awning too?
Yeah.
Then you would have the battle of the awnings.
Yeah.
So maybe if in the after season, when there's not much room and you don't put out the awning, we could go back there. But for now, we're moving on.
We've arrived, and it's a lovely spot. It's a farm, I think. And there's a big turbine. Old shit. And Patrick is gonna get the car. Gonna get Penelope. Well, buddies, we've installed ourselves. It is a lovely place. Hallo. And then I'm gonna show you the toilet building.
Come with me. We have to cross this bridge. This is the toilet building. Big windows. And here is the entrance. Yep. Let's see. These are the toilets with nice cow print. Toilet seat. Toilet one. And this is toilet two. Big window. And again, a nice cow print toilet seat. And toilet paper. Awesome. And here you have tourist information. The brochures you can take. That's very nice. And here's tourist information. And there's a guest book. And here are books if you want to read. Table, soccer table. And here is a nice sink to do the dishes. And a coffee maker. And over here we have the shower. Nice sink to wash your hands. Here, a little stool to put your clothes on. And yep, shower. You can take it off. Awesome. And you can adjust your own temperature. Wow, very spacious. New. And here's the other shower. Same thing. Big window. And a sink. And a mirror. Yeah, and a stool to put your clothes on. Hooks. Three of them. Very nice. And I forgot to show you, of course, the washer. Yes. There isn't a dryer. Yes, you can maybe use this one, but the lady of the house said if we want it dried, we can use her dryer. And if we want to do it ourselves, there's a place where we can wash or hang our wash up. Yes, she said if we want to dry our wash, we can use this one. This looks like it hasn't been used in a while, but it's very friendly.
Wow, that's luxury camping.
Yes, glamping.
Glamping.
Nobody.
We just went and got our mail in Amsterdam. And we got a letter here. It's, don't know who it's from, but when we opened it,
we found cards.
Scratch cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we haven't got the foggiest who it's from, but whoever you are, thank you. It's addressed to us, but a butt. And so whoever you are, mystery scratch card giver, thank you.
Donator of scratch cards.
Or Mr. Mrs. or Mrs. scratch card giver, thank you very much. Wow. You never guess how much. We won with one of the scratch tickets. It's the piggy bank.
Twenty. Wow, 20 bucks.
Thank you.
20 euros for the Powerball.
Wow, that's our summer secured. Awesome.
So thank you, anonymous scratch ticket donor.
Thank you very much.
What's that, Petra?
It's a new bling bling for Penny.
So we have a bit more privacy. So this is what you see from the cab area. Yes. Hello, buddies.
Hola.
What's Bob in?